So the purpose of our video project is to find out how much pressure it takes to shatter a fish tank. And in order to do this, we're going to use an example that we found inside our physics book and put it into real world action. So we're going to take a fish tank and we're going to get a PVC pipe, cut a hole in the top of this fish tank, seal the top on, and we're going to seal this pole into the fish tank. So as we pour water into it, the pressure from the column of water hopefully will shatter this fish tank.
Alright, so we have 15 feet of pole, and we need to find out how much that is in meters in order to find the amount of pascals needed to break the fish tank. And to get from feet to meters, we use a nifty picket fence. 1 feet.
1 feet.
1 foot has 12 inches. There are 2.5 centimeters in 1 inch. 100 centimeters in a meter. All of the units cancel out.
Yes, they do.
And using my TI-84, I calculated 4.572 meters.
Woo!
Find the maximum pressure that we can put on the tank. Use P2 equals P1 plus rho GH. And P1 is at 1 atmosphere, which is 1 times 10 to the 5th pascals. And then you're going to add rho, which is the density of water, which is 1,000 kilograms per meters cubed, times G, times the height we just calculated of 4.572 meters, which equals 144,805.6 pascals.
You can see that the P2 equals 144,805.6 pascals. And what we're looking for is the maximum pressure of the tank to be less than pressure 2 so we can get the tank to shatter.
Turn her on, baby.
Let her rip.
Let's pour those gallons in there.
More power? Not all you got, Captain.
Oh, shoot. Do you see that pressure building on top?
All right, now come hold the tube.
Keep going.
Run, Christian, run.
Run, like, no, you don't want to hold the tube, dude.
Right here we have the conversion for what 1 gallon is in liters. So 1 gallon is 3.78 liters. 3 gallons, which we got for this, equals 11.341 liters. And 11.341 liters equals 0.01134 meters cubed. We got that from this conversion. 1 liter equals 0.001 meters cubed. The volume of the cylinder is V equals power squared H. Power squared, which is the area of just that, is 0.068 meters squared. And just plug and chug into the formula, solve for H. We got the height to be 1.39 meters, and that is just this, not including this. This part is actually 13 inches tall, so we add those two together to get the total height of the water. And long, it comes out to 1.72 meters tall.
So the purpose of our whole experiment was to find out how much pressure in pascals it took to break a fish tank. So here we calculated the actual absolute pressure that broke the tank. So in order to find the pressure of the tank, we needed atmospheric pressure plus rho gh, which is kind of like we did earlier, but earlier we found the max pressure that we needed to break the tank. And now we're finding the actual pressure that broke it. So the pressure of the tank equals the 1 times 10 to the 5th pascals plus the density of water times gravity times the height that Lewis found earlier, 1.72 meters. And that pressure equaled 116,856. And that's the amount of pressure you need to break a fish tank. Beat.
Let's go.
Let's get her done. Just for you, Mr. Willard. I know you said we only had to do it once, but we're going to give you your own little picket fence conversion.
Are you taping right now?
Just for you. Heck yeah, I'm taping right now.
All right, so.
Let's get her done.